welcome back to Auto Repair, guys. If you guys have a Chevy Cruze or a Chevy Sonic, guys, what we'll be doing today, the video will be very helpful to you. We'll show you guys where the intake VVT solenoid is located and how to replace it. If you have an engine light on, okay, you most likely need to replace that solenoid. Engine light that relates to this solenoid, intake VVT solenoid. Now, there is a way to clean those, and we have the video on the channel. Please guys, check it out. We'll have more than 200 videos on this car and engine, so please guys, subscribe. Our mission is guys to save you as much money as we can by teaching you guys how to fix your car for free. So this is the engine. It's used in both vehicles, Chevy Cruze and Chevy Sonic as well. It's the same 1.8 Ecotec engine right here. And as you can see, guys, this is your exhaust side. Okay, this is your exhaust, this is your intake side. So the intake solenoid should be towards the back side, okay, and it will be right here, okay, this little guy. Now, I'll show you guys how to remove and replace that thing in just a second, but you have a safety connector here, okay, and that safety connector is on the back side, so I cannot show you exactly how to disconnect it, so I'll show you on the front one because it's easier to see. So this is the front one, but I can show you on the connector. You can see that yellow thing needs to come out like that. Then you can press in here and pull it out and disconnect it. Now, I'll go ahead and do the rear one so you know what I'm talking about. Okay, it's this one right here. So that yellow thing, okay, it needs to come out. Okay, sometimes you have to press them with the screwdriver if you haven't. Okay, perfect. Now I'll push in. Okay, it's still holding a little bit, so let me just move it a little bit more. Okay, came out. This is it. This is, guys, the connector I'm talking about. Okay, you can see if that thing is pushed in like that, all the way in, you will not be able to disconnect it. Once you pull it back, okay, this tooth, you need to press in and disconnect it. Now, what else we need to do? Okay, we need to get a reverse torque socket like this one here. Okay, and that socket, guys, okay, there is one bolt that is a little bit hidden, okay, over there. Okay, let me see on which side I can get that thing. Perfect. Now, all I have to do, okay, let me just switch my ratchet here to get it loose. Okay, and you can see usually once you start getting it loose, it will go by hand. Okay, pretty easy. So what I'll do, I'll disconnect the ratchet now, and I'll just go by hand. Okay, now it's super important not to drop your bolt. And this bolt, guys, is extremely hard to hold on to because it's very little bolt. Okay, this is it. This is the bolt. So that's what it looks like. Okay, you can see just like this one. Now, I'll go ahead. Okay. Let me leave it here so I know where it is. This solenoid might be stuck a little bit. So what I'll do right here, there is a place where I can just help it a little bit. Okay. With a screwdriver, because if that thing hasn't been removed, okay, believe me, it will be stuck. And it will be stuck really, really bad. So I just got through here, pried it a little bit, okay, and it came out, guys. We're going to leak some oil out, okay, that's for sure. So let me get one napkin quick so we don't make a mess here on the engine. Okay, pull it out, guys, and this is the solenoid. Now you can check out, guys, in the description of the video below where we get the new parts from. And the part numbers will be listed there as well. So thank you guys for watching. Putting it together is in reverse order. We took it apart. Thank you for watching and see you guys next time.